Students, welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. Today we are going to discuss about CMI examination. So after this video, you will have a basic knowledge about CMI examination, the syllabus, the eligibility criteria, the application form fees, and so on. So let us begin with our first topic, where we will discuss what is CMI and what does it provide. So basically, CMI, that is Chennai Mathematical Institute, is a center of excellence for teaching and research in mathematical sciences. So basically, it is a institute, and by the name only you can guess it has a main branch in Chennai and spread it all over India. And basically, its main focus is on mathematical sciences. As you can check here, we have Chennai Mathematical Sciences, and it was founded in 1989. And from that, after 1989, after the foundation, it as a part of SPIC Foundation, Science Foundation, and it has been declared to be an autonomous institute. And what does an autonomous institute mean? It means of state institutes, just like Delhi Institute or Calcutta University or anything like that. But this institute does not belong to any university. It is a autonomous institute since 1996. So by 1996, it has gained its autonomous institute. Now, we have it conducts entrance examinations for the graduation, undergraduation and post-graduation courses, and the subjects can be selected as mathematical, computer science and physics. And the courses it gives, courses it provides are BSc, MSc and PhD. So the combination of courses we have here is BSc is of two types. One is mathematics with computer science, and the other combination is mathematics with physics. Then we have MSc, where we have MSc in mathematics, MSc in computer science, and thirdly, that is last, we have PhD. So PhD degree can be obtained in either mathematics or computer science degree for all these three courses. Now we have the research group in mathematics and computer science at CMI are among the best and impressive collection of PhD students. So basically, by this you have come to know that Chennai Mathematical Institute is an autonomous institute and provides courses such as mathematics, computer science and physics, and it has nurtured, or we can say it has trained, many PhD students. Now let's move on to the syllabus part. So here you can check syllabus for the entrance examinations, and as I said, we have syllabus BSc in mathematics and computer science, then we have BSc combination, we have mathematics and physics, then we have MSc in all two, that is computer science and mathematics, then we have MSc in application of mathematics also, then we have PhD in physics. So beginning with BSc mathematics computer science, so basically what this entrance exam is for, this entrance exam is basically to test the mathematical knowledge, the mathematical knowledge of class 12 standard, not only 12 but before 12 also, up till 12 standard level they need to test the knowledge about mathematics. And there we have objective as well as subjective questions, and these topics covered under it is arithmetic, algebra, geometry, trigonometry and calculus and many more. So these are the main topics which are covered under the entrance examination. And BSc mathematics and physics, this course, this examination has the exactly same syllabus as BSc mathematics and computer science. And while giving examination, we need not select for which course are we giving exam. Once we clear the exam, after that we can select whether we want mathematics with computer science or we want mathematics with physics. Basically, both the syllabuses are same, and this mathematics and physics also is a test to know the knowledge about mathematics. Now moving on to MSc or PhD computer science. So as I said, we have MSc in two, computer science and mathematics, and there is a MSc entrance for application of mathematics also. Then we have PhD for all these three. We have PhD for computer science, PhD for mathematics and PhD for physics. So basically, in MSc as well as PhD for computer science and for mathematics, this syllabus is same. Here you can check the entrance examination syllabus is same for either we choose for MSc or PhD in computer science or in mathematics. So basically, for this examination for computer science, we know basic knowledge on computers and basic knowledge on computer science plus
we need some mathematical terms, mathematical knowledge, that is discrete mathematics, algorithm, and here we have basic computer organization and obviously programming. When we are talking about computer, programming is very important. Then we come to MSc or PhD mathematics. So in this also we will test the aptitude of mathematics for the bachelor's level. This time we need the knowledge of bachelor level with some topics, with some main most important topics. Here we have algebra, real analysis, complex analysis and calculus. So basically these topics we have studied in our lower standards like 11, 12 and as well as in our bachelor's, but in this entrance examination they require a very huge knowledge on these topics. So proceeding, we have applications of mathematics. In that also we will need to prepare for mathematics, and in this also we will have both multiple choice question to the last topic in syllabus. We have PhD in physics, and obviously by this name only you can say that this examination is generally for the knowledge of physics. So moving on to the academic programs offered at CMI. So as by the entrance examination you must know by now which programs are offered by CMI. So we will have BSc in two subjects, those are mathematics and computer science, as well as mathematics and physics, and both of them are 3 years course. A normal BSc course, it is obviously of 3 years course, and here also it is maintaining the same route. Then we have MSc in here, you can check, we have data science also, but main over here simplifies us as mathematics as well as computer science. Then we can have PhD in August previously, that PhD in physics, then we have PhD in computer science and PhD in physics. These main courses offered by CMI. So now let's move to the eligibility criteria. The eligibility criteria for the entrance examinations conducted by CMI. So each one of the different course, that is BSc, MSc, PhD, each one of them require a different eligible student. So each one has a different eligibility criteria, but here you can check in BSc, both the BSc, since we have same syllabus, same degree, so their eligibility criteria must be same. And here you can check, obviously before BSc we complete our 12th year, only 12th standard or equivalent. Just like equivalent means just in few different states where schooling ends at class 10 only, but in few states schooling ends at class 12. So it depends. So basically it depends, the eligibility criteria is a student must be a 12th past student for BSc. And for moving to MSc, in MSc you know a undergraduate degree is very much required, because before MSc the student must have been degrees such as BA, BSc, BE, BTech, any such degree with the subject they are appearing for. This subject's main base is required, such as if we are appearing for MSc mathematics, then we require a strong background in mathematics. If we are appearing for data science, so data science can have a background of mathematics or statistics or even computer science, and the degrees are same. We can have BA, BSc, BE, BTech, such degrees for this. And in computer science, by name only you can check MSc in computer science, which means we need a very strong background for computer science. And now coming to PhD, as you know, can be done either after bachelor's degree. The both criterias are eligible, that is if you are having a bachelor's degree in mathematics, because here we are talking about PhD in mathematics, then we can have a bachelor's degree in mathematics, or as well as we can have a master's degree in mathematics. Similarly in computer science and physics, we can have either bachelor's degree in computer science or MSc degree, that is master, or MCA degree, that is either we can have BE, BTech, BSc physics, or we can have MSc physics. So all these criteria fulfill a candidate for giving the CMI entrance examination. So after this we have the last topic, which is application fee. So once you apply for the examination, you must know how much you need to pay for just applying for the examination. So we have various ways of paying and various types of fees. So a postgraduate, wherever we are talking about MSc, that is Masters in Science, or we are talking about PhD. So whenever we are talking about MSc or PhD degree, we can face two application fee is Rs. 750 or Rs. 900. And why are there two different types of fees? We will discuss that later. So this these two basically depends on the combination of program, combine both exams. Just like we can apply just for MSc in mathematics, as well as we can apply in MSc in mathematics plus computer science also. So in case, in that case, if you are appearing for two examinations together, then we need to pay a higher amount, that is 900. But if we are appearing for only one entrance examination, then we need to pay 750. And here are a few ways in which you can pay the application fee. And if you are applying online, that is if you are applying directly through their site, after the application fee, after filling up the application form, there will be a link which will directly transfer you to the application fees, or you may say that once you pay the application fees, you will be directly transferred to the application form. So moving on to the other, if we pay offline, okay, so here we are, if we pay offline, we can pay through DD, that is demand draft. So for this category, we need to pay rupees 900 application fee. And once we pay the amount through DD, this DD should be sent with the form, that is we will get the form once the fees is enrolled with, once the fees has reached the institute. That is, we need to send the DD with the amount, plus we need to send a request for the form. Once we send the request for the form and they receive the money, we will be given a printed application form. And here you can check for online BSc applications. These conditions up till here we were talking about the masters. And for BSc, if we apply online, then we need to pay rupees 750, plus if we can pay through DD also, and the same procedure, we will get the application form in printed format. And now we may again talk about MSc PhD applications. So basically, you may see four categories. As I said above, we have two different types of fees. You can check, we have 750 as well as 900. So we can have combinations of subjects we need to give the entrance examination for. So you can check, first category is MSc and or PhD in mathematics. So in mathematics, either we can give MSc or PhD, or we can give both together. So if we give only a single, if we give either MSc or PhD, the amount we need to pay will be 750. But if we want to sit for both the examination, then the amount we need to pay is rupees 900. And category 2, as you know, computer science, we have another subject where we can have MSc or PhD both. So the same form goes on. And then we have MSc in data science. So data science, obviously we have only one examination, so for this we just need to pay 750 rupees. And PhD in physics, as I said, we do not have MSc in physics, so we have only PhD in physics. So basically, since this is only one examination, we need to pay for this as 750. And if we apply for multiple categories, just like if we apply for both category 1 and 2, or 2 and 3, or any such combination, then also we need to pay rupees 900, since we are applying for more than one examination. And you need not to take any tension about how much you need to pay, because once you fill up the form, the institute will directly tell you how much you need to pay, because the exact fee pay will be displayed once you fill out the form. So once you have applied for the examination, and once you have decided how many examinations you need to sit for, the institute will itself tell you how much you need to pay. So these were basically the basic knowledge about CMI examination. So I will like to end this video.